Greetings, everyone. So if you caught my video Friday from, or actually photo, sorry, from Clifty Falls State Park, I showed a picture of our camper here. This is a Flagstaff E-Pro 20 FBS, and I said I was going to do a video of it the next day. Well, we ended up going hiking most of the day and then rain. And then this morning when I got up, rain. So I had to wait till I got home. So I'm going to give you a full tour of the inside. I won't do the whole outside here. Long story short, we decided we wanted to go down in size in camper. We got a different truck. We got a Honda Ridgeline, which has a maximum tow capacity of 5,000, which is pretty standard on those mid-sized trucks. So we wanted something lighter, and typically it's just my wife and I. Every once in a while, our adult son or a friend or something will come. This camper comes in at just a little over 3,600 pounds. The farthest I've towed it so far, like where we went, was Clifty Falls. It was a dream. Like, it does great, excellent gas mileage. I think I was getting like 18, 19 miles to the gallon on I-65. So does a fantastic job. As you can see, all fiberglass exterior, nice big powered awning, which did get used this weekend. Side note, if you have a camper and it does get wet, make sure as soon as possible you can roll it out and let it dry. So I've still got to do that. So we'll go take a look on the inside. Solid entry steps, which are great. Nice big grab bar. Exact weight on this, I said 3,600. It's 3,648 pounds. So we were a little nervous when we bought, or when we decided to go with this, because we have a king size bed in our house and our old camper had a king size bed. And this isn't even a queen, this is a full. But I have to tell you, my wife and I both agreed after sleeping in it this weekend, it was no problem at all. And this was our first camping trip in it away from the campground this weekend. We took everything we needed. We had plenty of room and then some. There's under the bed storage, which we usually just keep extra blankets and stuff, as you can see in here. You've got drawers down here for storage, which we actually haven't had to use yet. I can't get a hold of that one. But anyway, those extra storage. You've got the his and hers closets on each side. USB as well as regular power and nice big nightstands. I charged my phone there. You've got some additional storage up there where you can put pillows, blankets, and actually we didn't even use the his and her storage, but as you see, it has hanging space as well as stacking storage space. I do have my gateway Wi-Fi router that I will be putting in here, booster/router. Those are great. I'll do another, it's the wine guard. I'll do another video on that. There is a video that we have on the site, pretty easy to get to, but those are real easy, just a couple of wires. And what's nice is if there's wireless at the campground, it'll boost that wireless, but you can put your own SIM card in there and have wireless or have internet while you're at the campground, which is great. Again, USB and regular charging on this side. This does have a solar panel on it, so right there is your inverter. The solar panel was fantastic. We ran our, which I'll show you in a minute, we ran our 12-volt refrigerator the whole way down there to keep our food cold, which was nice. We've got our seating here that will turn into a bed, so this technically sleeps three, but it also came with this really cool little table that we utilized the whole weekend. So we sat there, ate together, and then the one thing that we thought we were really missing was the fact that those don't recline, but we've got a little small ottoman that we pull out there to put our feet up on, and it was fantastic. We have some drawers up above here, which we kept some snacks, DVDs, paper towel holder, trash bags, sandwich bags, all that good stuff, some cleaning supplies. Show you the other one over here. Paper towel, microfiber wipes. Let's see, you got drink holders on each side of your couch. My wife found this for our dog. Since we had a smaller camper, we had to downsize his toy box. when you're sitting on the couch, you're directly across from your TV. What I really liked is that that is on a swivel. So we ended up, because we did so much hiking at Clifty Falls, we ended up actually laying on the bed in the evening and watching TV from the bed. It is a smart TV, but I also use a Roku, but I need to get something to fasten this up here and then hide the wires or the cables, of course. Sink, ample space for the two of us for doing our washing and stuff. Your control panel is over here, and as you can see, it's actually motion. It has a motion sensor in it, which is pretty nice. Run your slide in and out. This does have a small slide here to give you some additional space. Run your awning. I have the fridge on now. I'm actually going to turn that off now that we've got everything out. But you can run your water heater, your water pump, your step light, your awning, and check all of your tanks and stuff, as well as your battery. Stove, 3-burner stove, pretty standard. It's got the glass top, so you can use this for prep and serving space. Fold it back, and it's a splash guard for when you're cooking. This goes over your sink to give you additional, if I can get a hold of it one-handed, maybe. Yeah, this gives you additional prepping space, serving space when you're not using your sink. You do have some storage down here that we haven't had to utilize. We didn't utilize that one. We keep our utensils here. And then we've got odds and ends cutting board, and then kind of our drunk drawer with batteries, matches, and all that good stuff in there. Your refrigerator is right over here. I think all we have left in it is water from this weekend. We packed an entire long weekend's worth of groceries in here. Had no problems. We even had frozen pizza up here in the freezer. So plenty of space there. Nice size microwave, actually. We haven't even used it yet. AC controls right here. And I'll tell you, one of the really cool benefits of a small camper like this is that AC right there. I mean, it chills it off in here quickly. One other thing to point out while I'm facing this way is it does have this domed ceiling in it too, which gives it even more height and feel when you're in here. And last but certainly not least, we've got our bathroom. So, toilet, sink with a lot of countertop space. I'm not even sure what the missus has in here. Hand soap, and then our brochures from all the different state parks we've been to. And then another like toothbrush holder or something if you wanted. Nothing there. And then up in the medicine cabinet, we keep our towels and toiletries and shavers and all that good stuff. It does also have, I called that a medicine cabinet, it does have this medicine cabinet, which we haven't had to utilize at all. Nice big Max Air fan in here. We ran that pretty much the entire time because it actually wasn't that hot at Clifty Falls. So we just ran that to kind of keep the air circulating. Shower, I'm really impressed with. It's actually a very nice size. I'm almost 6 foot tall. I have no problem in here. It has the shower meister thing, so you can take your military showers in here because it does only have a 6-gallon water tank. It's not a tankless water heater. So you just flip this into the off, turn it on, soap up, or get wet, turn it off, soap up, and then turn it back on to rinse off to save water. But as you see, it's got this moonroof in it that gives you plenty of height. So I think that's about it. I mean, it's a small camper, doesn't take long to tour it, but our first big outing with it, we absolutely loved it. And I do want to point out one other thing. We did really like, we take our bikes with us a lot, and we usually end up putting our bikes either in the bed of the truck or in the camper. But this actually comes with a really cool bike rack. I'll show a video later on how you put the bikes on and off of it, because it was a little weird getting it set up initially. But once we had it set up, putting the bikes back on it in the rain today was actually a piece of cake. So if you have any questions or comments, as always, leave them down below, and have a fantastic day.